Let's find the x and the y intercept of the function given above. Okay, we're going to use the zeros that we just found to list out our x intercepts. Remember, that's always going to be the zero given, comma, zero. So, boom, and there are my three x intercepts. Very easy once you find the zeros. Okay, the y intercept is going to be zero, comma, the constant term, which is negative 18. So there we go. There's our intercepts.